The final credit category in LEED is indoor environmental quality. Green buildings with good indoor environmental quality protect the health and comfort of building occupants. High-quality indoor environments also enhance productivity, decrease absenteeism, improve the building's value, and reduce liability for building designers and owners. This category addresses the myriad design strategies and environmental factors: air quality, lighting quality, acoustic design, control over one's surroundings, that influence the way people learn, work, and live. I'm Dhwani Parikh. I'm a toxicologist at the US Green Building Council and manage technical development and implementation of materials and resources as well as indoor environmental quality areas within LEED. We have spent the last several years looking at real LEED projects to see what's working well and what can continue to improve. Now we are excited to share the evolution of our design and construction rating systems under LEED version 4.1. LEED system goals explain what LEED aims to achieve. The concepts within the indoor environmental quality credit category touch upon many of these goals, but obviously focus most directly on enhancing individual human health. According to a 2018 study, more than 80% of respondents say that being productive on the job and having access to clean, high-quality indoor air contributes to their overall workplace happiness. In addition, 85% of employees in LEED-certified buildings also say their access to quality outdoor views and natural sunlight boosts their overall productivity and happiness, and 80% say the enhanced air quality improves their physical health and comfort. The overall aim of the indoor environmental quality credit category is to help projects use design strategies that benefit the well-being of the people in the building. To achieve this, LEED version 4.1 aims to get people to think about the quality of their indoor environment more holistically. There are always trade-offs when designing and constructing a building, and within LEED, those could include balancing energy and indoor environmental quality trade-offs. But even within the indoor environment, there are trade-offs between different aspects. To be successful, project teams need to consider these qualities of the indoor environment holistically and consider how they impact each other. Here is the full list of prerequisites and credits in the indoor environmental credit category in LEED version 4.1 for design and construction. Collectively, this list represents a set of strategies for improving the indoor environment of a building. Let's walk through some of the highlights in LEED version 4.1. Updates to the minimum indoor air quality performance prerequisite to make LEED accessible to projects with natural ventilation. Naturally ventilated projects will find clear, appropriate requirements. In particular, we have a new option for building design and construction projects in historic buildings and interior design and construction projects in existing buildings, so they don't have to do a major overhaul of their ventilation systems. Another way we have made LEED version 4.1 more accessible is by allowing LEED for interior design and construction projects to be located within buildings that permit smoking, so long as smoking is prohibited within the project space. Also, we focus on the intent and acknowledge that project teams know the best way to manage and communicate their no-smoking policy. We restructured the low-emitting materials credit to be more straightforward while still promoting holistic consideration of the wide range of products installed in the building and how those products impact indoor air quality. Specifically, we lowered the percentage of products that need to meet the credit criteria and simplified the calculations that project teams use to demonstrate compliance by removing the budget calculation method option. We have also broken some product categories out, such as ceiling, wall panels, and insulation, so that projects can focus on a smaller set of materials or products and be rewarded for more incremental achievements. We also increased flexibility in the indoor air quality assessment credit through more approachable air testing options. We have also provided more approaches to air testing in form of new monitoring methods in addition to standard laboratory test-based methods, and revised the former extensive list of volatile organic compounds, or VOCs. Next, the daylight credit now gives projects more options for how to properly design for overlit situations. We have also revised thresholds and points for options 1, 2, and 3 within the daylight credit to make them more approachable for all project teams. Finally, we have reduced the scope of the acoustic performance credit, updated the requirements for sound transmission, and now give projects more flexibility on how to classify spaces. Welcome to LEED version 4.1. We think there's a huge opportunity for projects to take a holistic approach to their indoor environment and ultimately create healthier, high-performing buildings.